For me, data visualization is a very important thing. And if I got just numbers, I'm not able to make any inference from the data. And also each and every time, inserting a chart is also not a good thing. It takes a lot of time. So what do we do now if you had that thing for having a quick visualization of your data? We will use the Sparklines. Data presented in rows or columns is useful, but patterns can be hard to spot at a glance. The context for these numbers can be provided by inserting the sparklines next to the data. Taking up a small amount of room, a sparkline can display a trend based on adjacent data in a clear and compact graphical representation. Let's look at the data that's showing up on your screen right now. Here we have the sales of a particular chain of stores from January to December 2016, and there are actually 10 different stores. And you can see that the data of sales in USD thousands is showing over here. But for me, it's just numbers and I'm not able to visualize it. So either I go ahead and make different charts out of this, or I add the sparklines. So how do we add the sparklines? Well, it's a very simple thing. Let's say I want to add it here in column B. So I'll just go over here and I'll do a right click, insert, and let me name this as sparkline. Now I'm at store 1, cell B5. I'll go to charts, and from charts I'll select line. Then I'll select for store 1 all the sales numbers from January till December, which is C5 to N5. Then I'll press OK. There you go. You can see a small line that's showing up in the cell B5. I can also modify it to show the markers. I go over here in the ribbon and click on markers. If I want all the markers, I can select particular markers, or let's say in this case, I just want all the markers. I select all and click OK. And then possibly if you see there are different options for the line colors and the kind of markers, let me just select this one. So now you have the sparkline in one cell. You can just copy this cell and paste it in all the cells. And here you go. You have the sparkline for all the 10 stores. You can increase the width of the cell so that those markers are showing clearly. And now it's very easy to visualize the data. Note that this particular sparkline is a cell embed thing. So it's not a different chart altogether. It's embedded in the cell itself, and you don't have to worry about the chart getting deleted at all. There are many other options also within the sparklines. You can add columns, you can add positive, negative values as well. Believe me, if you have a lot of data that extends to a lot of columns, the sparkline will help you a lot in visualization. Although it's not mandatory for a sparkline cell to be directly next to the underlying data, it's a good practice. You can quickly see the relationship between a sparkline and its underlying data. And when your data changes, you can see the change in the sparkline immediately.